have 36 states plus FCT. And to get to know that my governor is among those who was selected to be given an honor, I feel great being a doctor.
Do you have any advice for him?
Yes, I say to whom honor is deserved. I believe having selected him, that means he has to do more work. Because giving you a recognition means you are doing well and expect more from you. Because it's what you've done that made them select you as one of you to be given honor. So that means from now on you do more and more is expected of you. So Deltaites are looking forward for what you do when you get back to Delta States.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
It's not somebody I can give an advice. I am privileged to be a part of his vision for Delta State, to be part of the team that works with him. For me, it's just to say congratulations because it's been a long time coming. I think that he deserves much more than even this. So just to answer your question, my advice is to say when people are alive and they get awards for work, for good work, it is an imposition that they have to work even harder. So, and I'm sure he's a man that I know gets less than 4 or 5 hours of sleep in every 24 hours. So I wonder what this will do to him now. He probably gets less than 2 hours sleep now. You know, he wants to outdo himself. So he's not a man that I have any advice for. For me, it's just to say congratulations. My personal honor and more grease to help, like I said.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay.
Richard, before joining criticism, but we noticed that when we get in there, it's a different world. Is there a difference?
Of course there's a difference, because your perspective becomes different. Your perspective becomes one of inside looking out. The process of government is different. So if you understand, when you begin to understand the process of government, you temper your criticism a little bit more. But that is not to say that the entire process, the entire decision-taking process and making process and arriving at execution of decisions cannot be made shorter. Because that's the desire of everybody that comes to the government. I was 47 before I got into government, so naturally I've been used to taking a decision and seeing it materialize immediately. So the more people like us participate in government, the more we want to see a balance between decision making and execution. So that's for me what's key, you know. And I think that is the entire process that is beginning to take place, because most people that are in politics today are people from private sector, and the more private sector people come into government, the more they will try to see how they can bridge, you know, the gap between execution and decision making.
Thank you very much.
Very happy that this national honor has been bestowed on the governor. When you look at the trend of his work in the past how many years as a governor, as somebody who came from the development world, I make bold to say that his achievements have been consistent in changing the lives of people. National honors are meant for people who have impacted in the lives of people and have excelled in their areas of discipline. We're very proud that as a professional, he has brought his sense of discipline, commitment, and love and care for the people of Delta State to bear in his work diligently as a leader who shows by example in the state. We're very happy to be associated with him, and I say congratulations. We wish that he will continue to work diligently in the way he is, focused, determined to leave a legacy for Deltans that will outlive his tenure. We're proud to have somebody like him.
Now, what will be your advice for his remaining part of work?
Well, my advice and my joy at the same time, because it's not just advice, is that he has this quest to leave a legacy behind, and as a government we are focused to make sure that we keep on track on the job he is doing. My advice to him and to his dear family is to keep the focus, keep the work going. When you are honored, it bestows on you a greater responsibility, you know. And so I encourage him, let me put it that way, I encourage him to keep up the good work.
All manners of trials, but as it is written in the book of Psalm 91, the Lord delivered him from them all. But as Psalm 91 says, I've delivered you and I will honor you. So the deliverance is not enough. The honor for the commander of the order of the night. And he goes on to complete it by saying, I will, with long life, will I satisfy you and show you my salvation. Your Excellency, sir, congratulations on this honor and welcome to the blessing, together with your wife and children, of very long life in God's salvation. Congratulations once more, sir.
Upon all his successes, now he has been crowned with a national honor. How do you feel?
I feel very, very good. I'm excited, really. You know, and I am really happy because by God's grace, his diligent work is paid off. And I know that this is just the beginning.
So what advice would you give him?
To continue in what he has been doing and even more. Because now with this honor, a lot is required. And by God's grace, I know him that he's a diligent person and he will not be found wanting at all.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.